If you have been on the internet recently, you've probably known about this.
Girl band FFX, whose music video Sugar Baby has bombarded the internet. But not because people like it.
鬧啦，踩啦，或者係粗口啦，係唔係好知點解會咁嘅。
In this month, Hong Kong Enquirer, we take a look at the latest development of Cantopop. Is the scene getting worse, or is the FFX phenomenon just a minority? And what would be the future for Cantopop?
This is one of the dancing studios where the FFX members practice singing and dancing. The studio is located in an industrial building in Kwai Heng in Kowloon. Their manager told me his company is very small and he could not provide much training to the members. Their music video, which cost only 900 Hong Kong dollars to make, received more than 2 million views.Many of the viewers were attracted by its sensationally poor quality.
你可以話條 MV 好核突，但係如果你話佢哋唱歌走音或者係跳舞唔得咧，我有保留，因為其實佢哋唱現場冇走音嘅。咁喺其實喺第二日咧，已經係有客户咧係打俾我。咁我以為佢講笑嘅，咁但係佢話：喂，你做演出啦，你哋近期紅啊！我話：咁都紅啊，你肯嘅咩？佢話 OK 啊，咁個價錢仲要係三級跳，我哋以前可能報幾多錢，人哋都唔要啊！
我覺得佢係特登醜化自己，又唔係講四個女仔，我係講個音樂，即係製作呢個音樂成個 production， 佢特登醜化佢，希望引人注意。
Chan is a veteran music producer who worked in the Hong Kong popular music industry. He was dubbed Andy Lau's golden producer, worked with him many times among other top-notch Cantopop singers.
In terms of quality, poor quality, 好唔正常咯，同埋好搞笑咯，歌詞又有啲騎呢啦。咁然後拍個 video 嘅話，我諗用兩部 iPhone 都可以拍得好過佢。
Tommy Tae is a sociologist who studies popular culture. The whole FFX phenomenon, he said, is in fact quite common in the history of Cantopop.
唱得好同唔好都唔緊要，個樣靚唔靚都唔緊要。Music video 拍得好唔好都唔緊要啦，最緊要多人留意，嗰個 attention 就已經係可以變做錢嘅一樣嘢啦，就係 monetization of viewership。咁嗰樣嘢反而就係變咗一個主流，更加重要嘅嘢。咁但係呢樣嘢係咪 everlasting 呢？It might not be the case， 即可能而家嘅明星仲快叫做玩完啦，即仲快就會消失啦。
FFX 完全不能代表而家香港呢個粵語流行曲嘅現狀。
If FFX doesn't represent the full scene of Cantopop， then what does？
十年前有外國嘅朋友入嚟物嚟香港。你問我而家香港最流行嘅歌手、最受歡迎嘅歌手係邊個？咁我會話俾你聽，陳奕迅咯。咁啊，咁如果再十年後再嚟香港嘅話，佢再問我，而家香港邊個最流行啊？咁我都可能仲係要答翻佢陳奕迅。那雙手靠擁抱，亦難任你擁有。要擁有，必
先懂失去怎接受。Christopher Chak was the composer of the album and considered one of the best Cantopop composers of this generation.
Do you think that the quality of Cantopop is declining?
I don't think so. I think compared to songs in the 80s and 90s, we have actually improved a lot. In these 10 or 20 years, we have generated a lot of our own songwriters, producers, arrangers, artists who can do their own music. There are songs that are receiving major attention. For example, recently the duet between KZ and Juno Mac.
But Chan has a different assessment of the current scene of Cantopop.
質量下降可以咁講，即係因為我覺得大家都係重複緊十年前做嘅嘢。
In fact, not all Cantopop singers are doing karaoke-style kind of songs.
主要的風格都是偏向韓風一點因為大家都知道現在�廣東是很流行和很熱大家個個見到的組合全部都很漂亮所以我們都很想在韓國那邊領取一些經驗廣東話是我們不會放棄的
As one was sent to South Korea earlier this year for a two-month training, they were also invited to perform in South Korean entertainment shows and sing in Korean language. It just seems that their songs have a full-out South Korean vibe, void of any Cantopop flavor. Some of their fans actually did not like them that way.
The lyrics in Cantonese, how they fit together with the music is very special. You know, it has a unique kind of beauty.
Chak told me he's still positive about the future of Cantopop. However, he also told me the budgets in the Cantopop industry have in general declined, even for some of the big entertainment companies. And because of that, Professor Chak told me he feels quite pessimistic about the future of Cantopop. In fact, many people share his views.
If there's a song that could describe the current situation of Cantopop, maybe it's KSS Hey Tip Guy, Wedding Card Street, a song about the faded good old times.